Comments. The Honourable Member for Calgary, Signal Hill.
Well, Mr. Speaker, I can't help but ask the member who is speaking if she's going to be voting for Bill C-29, because that's actually what we're debating.
The Honourable Member for Brampton South.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, my colleague. It is related to budget, even though it's Bill C-26, but it is related to budget, and so I'll answer according to that. Thank you.
Questions and comments. The Honourable Member for Winnipeg North.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I appreciate the comments from my colleague when she's talking about the importance of Canada's pension programs. In those pension programs, we're talking about the CPP, which she spoke so well on, but we also have the Guaranteed Income Supplement. And as she knows, the Government of Canada is substantially increasing the Guaranteed Income Supplement. And the government also reduced the age of retirement from 67 to 65 in terms of just allowing people to retire earlier, something that the Conservatives raised from 65 to 67. Given her obvious interest in terms of the pension issue, I'm wondering if she could just provide some comment in regards to how important all three of those pension programs are, the OAS, the GIS, and the CPP, in which she's provided comment on.
Honourable Member for Brampton South.
Thank you, my colleagues. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And I would like to thank my colleague for this elaboration question. And as we know, this is Canada Pension Plan, and it is also effect on the same effect as Bill 29. And the Canada Pension Plan, through its payment beneficiaries who are hardworking Canadians, which was over $45 billion last year, will allow the demand to increase, and it also a big impact on small businesses. Small businesses will grow. If small businesses grow, our economy will grow. So, of course, it impact on our economy, our economy is lavish, and then Canadian lives are also going to be lavish. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Questions and comments. The Honourable Member for Elmwood Transcona.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm just wondering, when the member ran in the last election for the Liberal Party and there were big promises made about investing in public infrastructure, was she aware at the time that $15 billion of that money was actually going to be used as a pool to attract foreign investment that would then partially or wholly own that important public infrastructure that they had run on a promise to build? And if she was aware of that, where in the Liberal platform was that written down? Perhaps she could enlighten the other members of this House.
The Honourable Member for Brampton South.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you, my colleague, for that. I thank my colleague for that question. Yes, Liberal Party has a big platform, and we did the promises, and we are almost fulfilling all the promises, like what we step by step, and also the CPP is like today, like I know I talk about the CPP is a universal system, one that is available to everyone who works, and need to be invest in that investment so our people can retire in a dignified life. The CPP Invest Board is very strong, and its management ensured that the funds and Canadian dependents on their retirement were secure. And this is a type of investment that is required to be collected for retirement future. That is why we did promise in our campaign. That's what we are going to fulfill that promise. This is also one of the promise we did back in the campaign. Thank you, Mr.
Resuming debate, the Honourable Member for Calgary, Signal.